What is that? Let's go! last time we played them, they had four. So we played four.
Yeah. Because I saw
five guys.
I saw him at the bench, so I figured five there was guys. Five in the game.
That guy's not playing.
I didn't bother counting. Good. They only have six though, huh?
Yeah, they have six, that's right.
One of, at the tryouts, one of Sydney's teammates from Elk Grove, I think his younger brother.
That's it, okay, we talked to him, yeah. Yeah, he's there kind of white hair, kind of.
The father?
Yeah, the father.
Yeah.
Kind of Indian looking.
Indian. Yeah, I'm not sure what
he's Indian, mom, Filipino. Yeah, okay. So, yeah, I talked
to him. His son's not bad. His son's a little bit taller.
Oh, yeah, taller, yeah. He needs rebound, whatever you do, you know. But, so how is it? Okay?
I mean, it was okay. My son, he hasn't been playing as much lately, so he's like, I don't know, he wasn't very aggressive. He's always just kind of like, kind of hanging outside and shooting outside, not really even driving.
Kind of up.
But they only have really mainly seven guys who try to. So
are they all good? Average?
They're all. No one's like, you know, I mean, they're only, you know, sixth grade going to seven, so nobody's like, you know, just like outstanding. But, you know, the kid who plays with Sidney, his younger brother, he's not bad. So, you know, he's like, he's a taller.
He got some skill, right?
Yeah, he's got some skill. There's some, I would say, you know, most of the kids are like average to a little bit above average. So, but you know, there's nobody that you just see is like, man, that kid's like really good, you know. But most of them are okay.
Yeah, he was with the bear, you know, rebel or something. The son? Rebel or something, but they're not really a team. Not really, you know, organized like Wall or us, you know, he's kind of more organized.
Yeah.
And the band, same thing like a band, he didn't even have one, so. So they're perfect for the Warlords, you know, seventh grade.
With the Barons, it depends on the families that, you know, are kind of talking about, like trying to select the team.
Yeah, exactly. This is more like an insider thing. Yeah. I mean, you got no chance.
No, but I mean, like, you know, it also depends on those families, because those are going to be the main families who are the ones who are trying to decide who to select.
Yeah.
You know, you never really have, you don't necessarily have buy-in from the families because you're just selecting the kids. So it just depends on how, you know, the dynamics of those families work out. Like, unlike our kids, that Barron's team, you know, it's mostly It's mostly Keelan's dad and Drew's parents that, well, Keelan's parents, not just his dad, but because of dad cultures. But it's like those two are the two main families. And then everybody else, you know, I've heard from some of their families that the other families don't do anything. You know, they gotta do everything. Like when they go to the Reno tournament, you know, they're hosting, right? But there's only like two or three families that are doing all the work because all the kids that they're selecting, the families don't come and support. But, you know, they still want the kids to play, you know what I mean?
Yeah, that's why I see, you know, the coach has been doing selling, cooking grind, selling things.
Yeah, they're doing everything.
Yeah, yeah, they don't really, you know, involve him, the parents.
So I don't know, we'll see. I mean, I could even see my son being like 50-50 as to whether or not they select him or not. You know, he did okay, but he didn't do, you know.
That's no guarantee, huh?
Yeah. And you know, the only thing that kind of scared me too was the coaching situation is kind of questionable.
Mm.
So what they have is they have two younger kids.
Mm.
One kid, my kids know, because he's 1 year older than my oldest son. Mm. My oldest son's only 19, so his kid's 20.
To coach?
So, yeah, so him and another kid around the same age, maybe a little older, they're gonna fill in first. And then the coach that they think is going to help, he's on some kind of, I forget what they said, but some kind of assignment that he won't be able to coach the first year, but he could coach, you know, hopefully the following year.
Oh.
But he's, he used to coach Mapache, they said, so, you know, yeah, I don't know any of these, because I didn't grow up in San Francisco, so I don't know any of these people, you know, but I don't know, well, I guess we'll see. The kid, I mean, he wasn't like an older guy, he was like maybe UG's age, maybe a little bit younger. The one who ran the tryouts on Wednesday was pretty good. He was pretty, like, very specific and to the point, and, you know, kind of, you know, he had a strong personality to kind of, you know, drive the kids. Not that the kids listen, but, you know, at least he's, you know, got a strong personality to try and get the kids to do what he wanted them to do. But yeah, it's funny because it seemed like there was a lot of cars, but then most of the cars are for like the people who are there to like, you know, run the tryouts and stuff. You know, there weren't that many people.
Oh, really? Probably people don't know.
Yeah, I don't know. I think there's just not that many kids that are playing the club ball for this age level, because one of my son's friends, he's on the parents team for going to be 7th grade, and they're not even. I don't really know their situation, but they're not even going to hold a Barron 7th grade tournament at Reno this year.
Mm.
You know how usually, you know, it's the first year, right? So you know, they hold it and all the teams come.
Yeah.
They're not even holding a 7th grade level team this year.
They don't have... Yeah, they never have.
Well, normally 7th grade is the first year they start.
No, they don't have 7th.
Is it normally 8th?
Always 8th.
Because I could have... I don't really remember. It's been too long.
8th? 8th?
Because I thought they do it starting at 7, but...
7, see? Remember, Nikal?
Yeah.
What's the same thing?
Carson.
See, Carson, yeah, see? He's the 7th right now.
No, he's 7th going to 8th, yeah.
Going to 8th, see?
Yeah.
But 7, remember when we host a tournament, they don't represent the band. They represent AAU.
Oh, did they?
See, he's not a band officially until next year, 8th grade.
I don't remember how it works when the kids were that.
So they don't have a set.
It's been too long.
Like a band, they before.
But they played though. I mean, even the Barons team, they played in like 6th and 7th grade. I don't know how they went though.
Well,
they might not have been as Barons. Like
the parents, the coach, you get together, coach AAU. So when times come, you know, 8th grade show up. It's just official Barons, that's all. So you don't have a chance to be a joiner unless you're on the team with the AAU.
Yeah, I don't know. The guy that we were talking about, his son that plays with Sydney with Elko, is he pretty good? He's not that tall.
Fast. Not tall, but quick. His son's quick. But he didn't play last year because of weight. So he tried again. Cherney, last name Cherney.
Cherney?
Cherney, Cherney. C-H-E-R-N-E-Y, N-Y, Cherney.
Because I didn't, you know, the only reason why I know was, you know how like when they talk to the parents, you know, mm-hmm. the kids are trying out, and mm-hmm. so they talk to the parents and tell them what the organization is about. Mm-hmm. They were talking about like what times of year that they play, mm-hmm. and then he brought up the fact that like, because well, Sydney, you know, he plays like, you know, not necessarily throughout the whole year, but he was talking about, you know, the time frames is what they yes. play, can't play and stuff.
Oh.
And I was like, oh wow.
Yeah, well, yeah. I talked to him a little bit, but we have games, so talk about, you know, Sydney playing Wolo, and then, you know, and then eventually he perfect. Yeah, and he checked out the Wolo.
Yeah, he made a comment about like some of the games he and you do like the scoreboard and the clock or something.
Exactly, but yeah, we do that, you know. Like when we host the
when you guys host the tournament.
When we host the tournament summer. And the regular school, some tournaments, yeah, we the parents have to do, you know,
yeah.
a few hours here and there, yeah, like that. Or sometimes, you know, the way the season starts, if nobody do the clock or both, we have to do it, the parents, one and two. You don't hire anybody for that.
Yeah, they gotta save all the money that they can save.
Yeah, not that, it's just customer. Everything one and two, pair of one and two. Only thing you hire is the refs and the cops, security.
Oh, okay.
They're expensive.
Yeah, yeah, I know the security gets expensive.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, you need 3 cops, 4 cops.
Yeah, whenever they have it at Laguna Creek.
Everywhere.
Yeah, I mean, I don't usually see the cops, but they usually park the car outside the gym, but I never really see where the cop is.
Oh,
you know what I mean? Yeah. Unless he's under...
No, we have the cop by the front door and the gym.
Yeah, I'm trying to remember. It's like when they, because like when they had summer league, you know, for the JV, because the JV summer league's
a... they don't need it. I think kind of liability, you know. Not the school, but the district required. So you pay attention when the school starts, you know, season starts. Not the tournament, but the... And you know, January, you know, regular season play league game.
Yeah.
Yeah, you see cops.
Yeah, yeah, I know what the varsity. Yeah, I know the cops are usually there. I was trying to remember, like during the summer, whether.
Oh, summer? No, summer you don't have that. No, no. I don't know why. Summer just they're not rowdy.
That's true in a sense that not all the kids play.
Yeah. You
know, like there's not that much participation.
No, the more actually summer a lot.
But I mean, you know, compared to like, let's say, if, you know, they had like, well, it depends on the school, sure. You know, some schools don't have that much, like Laguna Creek, there's a lot of number of people that like to play, you know, during the normal season.
Ooh.
I guess a lot of people are on vacation or something.
Oh, yeah. Wow.
points in the third quarter.
No. Only a minute. 2 minutes. Any good this year? No? No more pizza?
big guys. They only have a tall guy on the bigger guy. Yeah. super big. You know, he's like an average, like an Asian kid, because the mom was Asian. And so, he's taller than my son, so that's not saying a lot. And then the other kids are kind of hard to say, where like the parents are like medium size, you know, taller than me. And, you know, and they're bigger than my son, but it's hard to say how big, you know, they're going to grow. But they're husky too, so they kind of playing out there. They're like a medium to tall size team. But Sydney's teammates are quite far than he is. Yeah, there's a few families that are new to it. They probably have, that's probably the oldest son, oldest kid. Half of them have older siblings.
Yeah, Brandon, yeah, I know.
when you go to Long Beach.
Well, after the game, come home. Sunday. 2 weeks.
In 2 weeks. 2 weeks. Is it just, how many days? Is it 2 days?
2 days, yeah. Well, three games. Friday, Saturday, Sunday.
What do you want to get this
game? One game each, yeah.
I don't know if my cousin's making a little bit of a picture.
tap, yeah. Take your time, two at a time. Slow down, slow down. Take a break. Defense. Go Tata. Oh.
Almost. Got it. I got a lot of fouls to get. We still have five. Yeah, I get five more.
We have two.
I know, so I mean, if I get five more fouls, it's going to 1-on-1.
Sydney were lucky, you know, fortunate. They played for USL and then AU and that. The pan was the same three levels. Love basketball. So we don't change the codes all the time. Just the codes. Oh, you stay in the white codes. Play, like that.
The last team that he played during the summer, because they started playing really well at the end, they were talking about trying to get the same team. There was only like six kids. You know, getting them and maybe picking up some other kids and going to the Harvard College.
Yeah.
But I haven't heard anything. But that was only like a couple of weeks ago when I heard it. And the one guy who was coaching us, he's the dad of one of the kids, but he wasn't the original coach. The original coach had a job change or something.
Basketball, the pose, you know. Yeah, foul. One more.
At least go for the ball. You never know, right? Maybe you can slap
the ball. Go for the ball first! Try to steal the ball first! Okay, get a rebound. Yeah, the coach is seasonal. You know, coach one season, that's it.
Yeah.
And then skip.
Right there. same coach from the very beginning all the way to now?
No, a couple coaches, two, three coaches, but you know, still here and there. Something playing too, you know?
Yeah,
so it's not like a volunteer coach, you know, you can do that. They're not gonna last long. But you're the senior center, only those two.